everyone here had to escape from Syria. I'm Syrian Kurdish. From the childhood, I'm living in Syria. I was living in Kabul. There is no Kabul now, I think.
Thank you.
It's collapsed completely. I arrived in Kurdistan for 1 year and 2 months. Before I had to escape from Syria, I was working as a specialist in emergency medicine. Now I'm working with MSF in the camp.
This morning is normal. Every morning is like this. This camp population is more than 50,000. All cases you can imagine we see here.
People here have seen bombing, shellings. Sometimes family members die. Pictures in their heads they cannot get rid of.
Bizen, how are you?
There are very difficult living conditions here in the camp. If anybody could tell them, okay, you have to stay here for another 2 months and then you can go back home, people would cope easily. But nobody can tell them when they can leave the camp or if they can go back. It has a very big impact on the psychological well-being.
We don't know exactly what will happen on the borders, if more refugees will arrive or not. But I wonder and I think about these people. I wonder how could be our situation in the future. Maybe it will be better. But it's not clear for me.